Amy, and Filbert's resting in his hut. This is the second part of a two-part series on training your guinea pig. That's what we're gonna talk about today on Filbert and Friends. So what I did was took a very shy guinea pig, being Filbert, and I looked at how you bond two guinea pigs together, which is to give them a bath and wrap them together in a towel, and that's how you help to bond some guinea pigs together. And I adopted that to work for Filbert and me. What I did was let Filbert have his hut, his kind of safe space on the couch here with me, and then he was too shy to come up and get with me where I was laying down beside him. So I started to pull a sheet over his enclosure or his hut and over me as well. And pretty quickly, he started to come out and he'd get nearer and nearer to me. And eventually he started jumping up on my chest and laying down and doing all the things Filbert does. It was just a matter of giving him a safe space in which to explore me and his environment. So we did that with the sheet and it worked really well. Filbert's in a stage where I'd say half the time he needs the sheet and half the time he doesn't need the sheet, he'll just do it on his own. So I think he's gonna progress to where he doesn't need the sheet eventually. What's kind of cute is Filbert even hears the sheet crinkling, like I'm about to pull it over me. He starts to perk up his head and get excited and starts to come out of his hut a little bit and get his footing. So that's worked really well for me. That's my suggestion for bonding. And that's really what training a guinea pig is about. It's about earning their trust. Anything else, like specific to tricks or something like that, that's really not something that's part of my experience with guinea pigs. And perhaps there's information that you can find on the internet. But for Filbert and Friends, we work on bonding and we work on relating to each other in a safe environment. I'm Amy, this is Filbert, we're Filbert and Friends. Thanks for watching. Filbert, you don't say. What happened next?